And we are now ready to prove Euler's theorem that will help us to find passes visiting every edge in the graph exactly once. Actually, we will be focusing on the Eulerian cycle problem. Find a cycle that visits every edge in the graph, because Euler was interested in a walkthrough Königsberg that starts and ends at the same place. There is cosmetic, very small differences between finding Eulerian cycles and Eulerian passes. As soon as we learn how to find cycles, we will learn how to find passes, and vice versa. Let me start from a question. Does this graph has an Eulerian cycle? Or in other words, is this graph Eulerian? Of course not, because there is no way out of the red node. What about this graph? It's also non-Eulerian, because there is no way in into the red node. And what about this graph? We need to look a little bit more closer, but we will immediately find a red node here for which there is one incoming and two outgoing edge, which means that this graph cannot possibly be Eulerian, because in every Eulerian cycle, the number of times we enter into a node equals to the number of time we leave the node, and therefore the number of incoming edges in every node should be equal to the number of outgoing edges from every node. We call a graph balanced if in degree of every node equal to its out degree. Or in other words, the number of incoming edges into every node equals to the number of outgoing edges. Is this graph balanced? Of course, we can check that for every node there are two incoming and two outgoing edges. But it doesn't help us yet to figure out whether there is an Eulerian cycle in this graph. And now we are ready to present Euler's theorem. We already saw that every Eulerian graph is balanced. So this graph has a chance to be Eulerian. Euler proved that every balanced graph is Eulerian. Of course, balanced and strongly connected, because if the graph is disconnected, there is no way to find an Eulerian cycle. Let's prove this theorem. And to prove this theorem, we need to recruit an ant and let it randomly walk through the graph, of course, with the condition that the ant cannot visit the same edge twice. Let's start. If ant was a genius, then he would simply walk along the graph, as I show here, visited all edges of the graph, and finally return back. But an average ant wouldn't be that lucky, and it would start traveling through the graph, start walking, and eventually it would get stuck. Let's stop for a second and think at what node this ant can possibly get stuck. Can it get stuck in the middle of the graph? Presumably not, because our graph is balanced. And therefore, every time the ant is entering into a node, there should be a way out of the node. This condition holds for all nodes in the graph except for one. Which one? Of course, it's the starting node of the ant, because in this starting node, the ant has already used the first outgoing edge, so it may arrive in this node and there will be no outgoing edges left. And therefore, what we learn is that the ant can only get stuck at the node where it started. What can we do afterwards? The ant failed to construct the Eulerian cycle because it didn't visit all edges of the graph. But maybe, just maybe, we can start at a different node in the green cycle. Let's start at a different node at the green cycle. Also, it's not clear what difference does it make, but why shouldn't we try to start in a node in the cycle where there are still unexplored edges? For example, at this node in the cycle, there are still unexplored edges left, so let's force that to start here at this node. And in the beginning, let's tell them, first, follow the same cycle you constructed at the previous step. So the ant start working along the green cycle. The ant absolutely doesn't understand why he has to do this kind of silly work working along the cycles that he already constructed. But finally, he arrives to the initial node, and now he realized that actually now he can continue working because there are still unexplored edges from this node. Then continues working, and finally got stuck. And of course, it got stuck at the same node where it started. What we should do today, afterwards, we should start at another node with still unexplored edges. Where is this node? B? Well, this is the node with still unexplored edges. Then first, we'll be ordered to traverse the cycle that has been already constructed. This is green-blue cycle, and then starts, continue. Then is not happy, but it's okay. Continue, and finally arrives to the initial node. But now, Zen realizes that the instructions were not that stupid because there is a possibility to explore further. And we continue, and finally, Zen constructed the cycle that we wanted, that visits every edge of the graph exactly once. Not only and constructed this cycle, we actually just came up with an algorithm for doing this, and this pseudocode described our instructions to the end, and you can implement it, and it will result in an efficient algorithm. And if we would now put an end to search Dibrand graph constructed for universal strength, in this case, just in three iterations, it will construct Eulerian cycle, and therefore construct a universal strength. You can check that you will be able to derive universal strength from this cycle.